Alrighty, so I went to Home Depot again and I got a few things. I got some angle brackets, I got some hinges, there's more in the bag. I got an 8 foot long piece of tin. Really didn't think too much about the width. I guess maybe I needed two of these, but I only got one. And it measures 2 feet 3 inches on the short end. So that probably means that it was designed that way to have the overlap so that you can count it as a 2 foot section. So what does that mean for me? It means if I buy one more and overlap it with the 3 inches, then I completely cover the whole top of it. So that's one option. Another option is for me to turn it sideways and have part of the chicken coop have a tin roof and part of it not. So I also bought 6 more boards. And now I'm back out here to finish making this end piece, and then I can work on a second end piece. I did consider lining it up better, because it's actually gonna be 1.5 inches off because of the way I butted the joints together. These end pieces will be taller by 1.5 inches. I'm actually having a hard time envisioning that, and in one sense the easiest way is for me to fix it right now, to unscrew this. But see, I don't know, I've started to nail down the screen, and I think I'm just going to go with the idea that I'll figure out a solution for the 1.5 inch difference once I get to the end. Right now I'm going to proceed with nailing it up, hacksawing the screen off. Hopefully there'll be enough left in that roll to do the other 4x4. Then I can line it up and dry fit it. So the number of boards that I bought will be enough for another 4x4 section. It will be enough for the top. And there's one or two more boards, so that, let's see, what was the reason? Okay, in case I needed to do 45 degree angles for support. And depending on how it turns out that I need to put the corners together. That's where I'm not sure if I'm going to do something with angle brackets or 2x4s in order to turn the corner to go from long side to short side and make it into a rectangle. I might even need a lip for the, if I do need something like that, I would maybe do a furring strip, or a little angle bracket. I kind of have this in my head, but, that's the progress. Charlotte is doing good. I mean, we're slowly but surely getting used to each other. What I did this morning, or maybe around noon, is I had her do some laps, and she still is not doing that voluntarily, but I had her do a few laps in the pool, one after the next, and she tried to get out the side, which she was successful at one time, but then I kept on encouraging her to come all the way to the steps. So it tires her out a little bit and gets her exercise, and it's exercise that's good on the muscles. You know, they say that pool exercise is really good. It just mellows her out just a little bit, and so I think it's working. I also tried to do something which I thought may have been clever, but the animal shelter is right across from Home Depot. And I still have it in the back of my mind about a cat. I think actually a barn cat would be perfect for what I'm doing, you know, as far as homesteading type things. But they had some like canary birds in there. They had reptiles. They had, I didn't see any hamsters or guinea pigs. Oh, they had bunnies. They had large bunnies. So, I mean, I can keep going with these types of units, and, I'll be able to get the animals. And they did say that that shelter doesn't have livestock typically, but the, other counties that are a little bit further out, they do sometimes get like, pot belly pigs and things like that. So I'm just getting very excited about, you know, going one type of animal at a time and getting them added to my homestead. Now, one other thing that I need to think about is winter, where, like a potbelly pig might be able, you know, although a potbelly pig, I think people actually keep them indoors, oddly enough. But point being that some animals are relatively okay for the winter, and some you'd have to do different sorts of things and maybe be around electricity. So for instance, this chicken run, I may end up putting it in the back of the house. And I already know that there is a particular panel that almost looks like a TV screen that you can buy. It's very safe to use and plug it in. So I could plug it in through a window, you know, crack a window, plug in the panel, have the chicken run in the back. I guess at this point in time, I'm getting more towards thinking that this may turn out to be their permanent residence. During the summer, I don't have to necessarily come up with the full solution in the summer, but as it approaches winter, if I'm all set up with the chicken run, then what I could do is find a way to get this house. To get this house in some way, shape, or form to be a part of it. You know, there's already like a brooder box and like a place to access the brooder box and get the eggs. I mean, it would be kind of interesting if I actually positioned this so that it faced the window so I could just access it right from the house and reach in and get eggs. But first things first. All right, I'm coming back, Charlotte. She kind of accidentally stepped right into her harness today. I was just sly enough to be able to do it. And now you're okay with it, right? We'll just have to keep doing that kind of a thing. Oh yeah, I think the story that I was telling about the animal shelter is that they have an enormous collection of donations from people where they bring in leashes and food and dog toys and all sorts of things. And so when I went over there, you know, I knew that I just haven't done it yet, but I know that I have to get myself out there and buy dog toys and things. And so I thought, okay, well, I'm not really sure what their rules are. And I asked, and yeah, you have to actually be adopting a pet right that very day to help yourself to any of those donations. Otherwise, I could have got some freebies, and it just would have been convenient because, you know, once I did the trip to Home Depot, my vision was blocked in my car with the piece of tin, so I didn't want to go anyplace else but home. So, okay, that's all. Bye-bye.